The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 4th chapter, text number 14, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on April 3rd, 1974, in Bombay, India.
Translation: There is no work that affects me, nor do I aspire for the fruits of action. One who understands this truth about me also does not become entangled in the fruitive reactions of work.
Namang karmani limpanti, name karma phalishtriha, iti manjo vijanati, karma vi nasabaddhate. Last night we discussed Chatutvarnamaya system, Gunatanma Vibhara. There are two conditions of life. Actually, conditioned life and non-conditioned life. Liberated life and conditioned life. That is real novelty. Liberated life and conditioned life. Conditioned life means this material world. We are conditioned by the laws of material nature. Just like we are trying to go to the moon planet, but we are conditioned. We cannot go. There are so many impediments. This is the nearest planet. Still, because we are conditioned, we cannot go. No free access. Otherwise, a living entity name is Sarvago. Sarvago sthanu rachuloyam. Sarvago means a living entity can go anywhere. As you see, there are so many planets. Why you cannot go? There are means also. We are flying in the air, but we cannot go. This is called conditioned life. There are so many instances. Just like even on this planet, if you want to go to other countries, say America, you have to fulfill so many conditions. Passport, visa, then P-form and so many other forms. Not easily. This is called conditioned life. We have no freedom to move. And there is another life, which is life of freedom, just like Narad Muni. Narad Muni travels everywhere. He goes in the spiritual world, he comes in the material world. In the material world he can go in any one of the planets. Sometimes by yogic practice he can go also, but not so easily. So there is a life of freedom. That is spiritual life. Nitya mukta. The living entities who are living, who are residing in the spiritual world, their number is greater than the conditioned soul. Just like some of our friends or citizens, they are in the jail. Their number is not as many as we are free. Similarly, the number of free living entities in the spiritual world is greater than the number of the conditioned souls. If you only, we are conditioned. And this condition means karmani. Karmana daiva natrena. Jantar deho upapatti. as you are doing work, creative activities, under the influence of a particular type of modes of nature, you are getting different types of bodies. And there are 8,400,000 forms of bodies, and you are rotating. Because you do not know, you have forgotten how to become free from this cycle of birth and death and transmigration of the soul. This is called karma. Yajñārtha karma anyatra lokāyaṁ karma bandhana. Therefore, in the human form of life, we must perform yajña. Yajna means to satisfy the Supreme Lord. Yajñārtha, for the sake of the Supreme Lord, for satisfying Him. That is our business. So, to do that business, in the previous verse, it has been prescribed that the human society should be divided into four classes of men. There are, but they should be systematically divided. Just like in any office, there are departments. Without departmental work, nothing can be successful. Anywhere you go, either in the law court or in the office or anywhere, there must be departments. Similarly, the human society must be divided into four divisions. Not four divisions, eight divisions. Varnasa. In the Vedic literature, there is no such thing as Hindu dharma or Muslim dharma or Christian dharma or Buddha dharma. These are recent manufactured. Actually, Vedic instruction is to divide the whole human society into four varnas and four ashrams. That is Vedic dharma. Sanatana dharma, it is called Sanatana. A living entity has got the chance of getting this human labdha sudurlabam, bahusammavant. Bahusammavant means after many, many births. This present rascal civilization does not know how with great difficulty we have come to this human form of life after so many evolutions. The Darwin's theory of evolution, there is some idea, but it is not clear, not scientific. They are trying to prove that scientific, that is not scientific. But the evolution theory is there. 8,400,000 species of life, Javajanam, Lakhani, Sthavara, Lakhamini, Sati, like that. Brahmadhi, you are rotating in this way. So, the human form of life must be systematized, not live like animals. So therefore, if in the human society there is no the systematic division of person, the aim is one. It is not that because one is in the lower division, he does not get the benefit. No. Just like in the state, in an organized state, as you have seen in foreign countries, especially in USA, very organized state, everyone has got the facility. Doesn't matter whether he is rich man or poor man. Everyone has got. Similarly, this Chatudvarnamaya system, Brahman, Kshatri, Vaishya, Shudra, it doesn't matter. One is Shudra or one is Brahman. But everyone has got the facility to become connected in relationship with the Supreme Law. Manghi Partha Vapasitya, Jepishu Papajune, Tatha, Triyavasya, Tatha, Shudra, Stevi Janti, Parangati. Parangati, that is open for everyone. It is not that because one is Shudra or one is Chandala. He is not allowed to enter into the kingdom of God. Only the Brahmanas are allowed. No, it is not like that. The same thing, same example, that in the body there are four divisions. The head division, the arm division, the belly division and the leg division. It is not that only the head gave the facilities of living condition. No, everyone. But there must be division. That is scientific. Otherwise the human life will be spoiled. That I have tried to explain last night. There must be division because it is ordained by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, how we can violate. There must be the Brahminical class, the Kshatriya class, the Vaishya class, and the Sudra class, then everything will be maintained very proficiently. Because it is karma, karma jagat. Material world means you work and you enjoy or suffer the result of your work. This is material world. Everyone is given facility, but it is karmanubandha. Karmanubandha. Thus the facility for the living entities who wanted to enjoy this material world. This material world is not wanted. Everyone should live in the spiritual world. There is spiritual world. Parastasmātu bhāvanya bhaktya bhaktya sanātana. There is no birth and death. Jadgatyāna nivartanti taddhāma padhīja. Everything is there. People do not know it. Therefore, the karma should be systematized and it should be regulated by Brahminical culture, by Kshatriya culture, by Vaishya culture, by Sudra culture. But Krishna says that don't think because I have prescribed this for the systematic life of all those conditioned souls, it does not mean I am also one of them. Krishna is not one of them. And some foolish rascal, they say, the Krishna also is bound up by the laws of karma. No. Krishna is not only Krishna, but Krishna's devotees also. That is stated here. Iti mādhyo vijānāti. Karma bhi nasabaddha. Simply by knowing that Krishna is transcendent. Krishna gives us prescription how to live in this conditional state. But he is not one of us. He is not one of us. He is above, transcendental. Therefore he says, namaṁ karmāni limpanti. Because Krishna is fighting in the battlefield, he is not fighting, he is directing. Still, you may call that he is inducing Arjuna to fight. But that does not mean he is becoming entangled in the karma fall. Namaṁ karmāni limpanti. Apāpa viddham. Krishna is killing so many demons. He is not bound up by karma. Similarly, if we also become devotee of Krishna, and if we abide by his order, then karma fall cannot touch us. This is bhakti. Karmani niddhati kintucha bhakti bhajan. That is stated in the Brahma Sangita. Jastindra gopa matavenda maho sakarma karmanu phalam abhajanti. There are millions and millions of living entities, beginning from the king of heaven whose name is Indra. Jastindra gopa matavendra maho sakarma. Beginning from that Indra, and there is one worm that is called Indrapo, very small. You have to see with microscope. Very small, insignificant living entity. And that Indra king of heaven. It's very important. So beginning from that Indra up to this Indra, everyone is bound up by the fruitive resultant action of his karma. This is called karma yama. Jastindra gopama samendra maho sakarma karmanu phalam avajant. Going on under the laws of karma. Karmani niddhati kintucha bhakti bhajan govindamadi purisam tamahundu. The goat, just like Arjuna, was hesitating to fight because he thought that I shall be entangled in the karma fall if I kill my family man and my grandfather, my teacher. So he was thinking that was good, consideration, papa punna. But because he fought for Krishna, because he satisfied Krishna, he was not bound up. Jagyarthi karmannatru lokayam karma. If you do anything for your satisfaction, then you become entangled in the karma fall. But if you do anything for the satisfaction of Krishna, there is no karma bondage. This is the secret. That is clearly stated. Namam karmani limpati. He is the supreme. He can direct, but he is not under the direction. He is free. Similarly, those who are Krishna's devotees, they are also free. Jumang. Jumang abhijanati. Abhijanati means one who knows that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He is not ordinary human being. He is nitya nityanam, chetana chetananam. He is the supreme living entity amongst all living entities. He is the supreme living being amongst all living beings. That is abhijanati. Abhijata knows with complete experience, not superficially. Iti me jo maam abhijana. Abhijanati means knows me perfectly well that Krishna is transcendental. And that is also explained by Krishna. Marchabhyavicharini bhakti yogena jasevate sagunan samatita itan brahma bhujaya kalpate. So those who are engaged in the bhakti yoga, unflinching bhakti yoga, unalloyed bhakti yoga, such person is above this material entanglement. Material entanglement is within the modes of material nature. That is Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, or Brahmachari, Grihastha, Vanaprastha, Sannyas. This is 8 divisions. From material condition, if you want to be promoted to the spiritual platform, then these are the regulative principles. Either you become Brahmana or Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra, or Brahmachari, Grihastha, Vanaprastha, Sannyas, and gradually develop your spiritual constitutional position and be transferred to the transcendental position. Parastasmatu bhavanya bhakta bhaktasana. That is the process. But if you live in the condition like animals, then you continue the life of animals, eating, sleeping, mating, and defending, and struggle for existence. Manasasthani indriyani prakishisthani karse. Then you struggle within this material world forever. Sometimes you become the king Indra, and sometimes you become that jarn Indra. This is karma. This is karmaphal. But we are so ignorant of this law of karma, we are thinking that this position of American or Indian or this or that for 50 years or 60 years at most, that is one, everything, all in all. There is no more life. Yes, I talked with many big professors. They are under the impression, atheism, voidism, that after death there is nothing, everything is fine, finished. Atheism. Vasya bhutasya devasya kuta punaragamana bhavet. The body is burnt into ashes. Who is coming again? This is atheism. Because the atheist cannot say, see the, how the soul is transmigrated by the subtle body from one body to another. They have no gross materialist. So we should not follow the gross materialist, but we should follow the perfect leader, Krishna, who says, Tatha dehantara prati, dhira svatthanavi. These we must follow. That is human civilization. Therefore he prescribed that Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. Either you become Brahmana or follow the instruction of the Brahmana, then your life is perfect. Both things are there. If you like to be Brahmana, that you can become also. Manhi Patha Bepasitva. This is Krishna consciousness movement. Because in this age, everyone is a Shudra. Kalo Shudra Sambhava. There is no culture. There is no Brahminical culture, Kshatriya culture. Therefore, altogether, they're simply Shudras. So, this Krishna consciousness movement is to raise the Shudras, or less than that. Manhi Partha Bapasitta Jekishu Papa Junaya. Plural number. Triyavishasatha Shudra. The Papajani, also Sri Murti is also Papajani, Shudra also Papajani, Vaishya also Papajani. This is Krishna's faith. But everyone is open to come to him. Everyone. It doesn't matter. And there are less than that. Less than they are called. Chandalas. They are also mentioned in the Bhagavad. Kirata Hunanda Pulinda Pukkasa Adhira Sumba Javana Kasada. Jinne to papa. Again, less than them. Jodupas Rayas Suddhanti. They can be purified. They can be purified. Prabhu Vishnu Venama. The Lord Vishnu is so powerful that he can make anyone a purified Vaishnava. That is his special. It is not that because one is Kirata Hunanda Pulinda Pukkasa or Papujani, he cannot be elevated. He can be elevated. That is possible because guna karma vibhagata. If you make him qualified like a brahmana and work like a brahmana, then he can be elevated. That is Krishna consciousness movement. We are trying to educate anyone. It doesn't matter. Because Kirata Hunananda Pulinda Pukkasa, anyone, Janni Cha Papa, everyone can be elevated. So who will do that? Krishna says that anyone can be elevated. Manhi Pata Bapasitva Jepi Supavajana. So who will do that? Therefore Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has said, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is also Krishna, na bharat bhumite manushya janma haila ja. Janma sarthak kari karo paropaka. Indian, this is the duty of the Indian, bharat bhumi. One who has taken birth in the holy place of this bharat varsha, it is his duty, make his life perfect and do welfare activities for others. This is India's business. This is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's order. Bharat bhumite manushya janma haila ja. Janma sarthak kari karo paropaka. India is meant for paropaka, not for exploiting others. That is not India's business. That may be for the fools and duskers in other countries. But in India is dedicated. Therefore, in India Krishna comes. In India, Lord Ramchandra. But they are now taking it very cheaply. All rascals and fools and rogues, they are claiming that I am Krishna and Ram. They are taking it because India has fallen. Because there is no Brahminical culture. They cannot understand these rascals. that the poor land rascals are claiming to be Krishna. Krishna is so cheap? No. That is our misfortune. That instead of Krishna, we are accepting some imitation, rogue Krishna. This is our misfortune. But we should not do that. There is Krishna. Here is Krishna. In his world, Krishna is absolute. He is not different from Krishna. The words of Krishna and Krishna, there is no difference. When you read Bhagavad Gita, if you feel like that here Krishna is speaking before me, then your life is okay. Krishna is, that is, actually it is a fact. It is a fact. It is not that Krishna is no longer here, 5,000 years he spoke, therefore this Bhagavad Gita has become Nalanda. This is nonsense. Krishna can speak at every moment, every second. Premanjana Surita Bhakti Vilochanena Santas Sadaiva Ridaye Surilokayanti. Those are Santas. Therefore it is said here, Iti Mangyo Vijana. So that is said that simply in this age. No, at any time. Iti Mangyo Vijana. One understands Krishna. At any time, at any place. Itimān jo vijānāti karma bhi nasa baddhate, he becomes liberated person. Simply by this understanding, that Krishna is the Supreme Lord. He is not bound up by the laws of karma, and he is not conditioned by this material nature. Krishna says, Devi desha gunamai mama maya duratvaya. Mama Maya. Maya is under his control. Maya dhaksena prakriti. Maya dhaksena prakriti. Prakriti is working under his direction, under his superintendence. So we should know Krishna like that. We should not. Abhijananti manamura manasim tanumas. Because he is speaking like a man, we are thinking that he, Krishna came. And Krishna is now dead, and his instruction is also dead, obsolete. No, that is not. Krishna is ever existing, nitya nityanam. We are also ever existing. We are covered by this material body, but Krishna is not covered by the material body. He comes in his original body, sambhavami atmamayaya, yuge yuge sambhavami atmamayaya, pariktana sadhuna vinasaya sudhisthita. So Krishna comes to save us and gives us his instruction so that after his disappearance from this world, people will take advantage of his instruction and make his life perfect. This is Bhagavad Gita. But if we misuse our intelligence and do not take advice from Krishna and manufacture so many plans for prosperity, that will all say, mogasa moga karmana. Moga jnana vitetasa. That is, mogasa. Mogasa is frustrated, they will be frustrated. Mogasa. Only one who does not take the direction of Krishna, then whatever he is hoping, that will be frustrated. Mogasa moga karmana. And whatever he is planning, I'll do like that. That will not stay, because the Maya is there. Daivijji sagunamai mama maya duruttaya. Maya will kill all your plans. Mami vajapravadnante maya metam karanti. And if you follow Krishna and do accordingly, then you will not be frustrated. Your life will be successful. This is the philosophy of Bhagavad Gita. Therefore, we are trying our little effort, how to establish the truth described in the Bhagavad Gita. So, do not take this Krishna consciousness movement very lightly. Take it seriously and try to understand, and your life will be successful. Thank you very much.